This video shows you how companies and business organizations are used in BMC Remedy ITSM and BMC Service Level Management, or SLM, and provides some basic information about how they are configured. After watching, you should be able to determine which organizations to create for your environment and what information to gather before creating them. A company in ITSM and SLM is part of your foundation data and represents a real-world company. You can use a company to represent your internal support organization, an external support provider, the consumer of those support services, a manufacturer of products that you use, a supplier of those products, or another type of contact. You can also use companies to represent business units within your company, especially when you want to control access to data. If you are using ITSM and SLM in single tenancy mode to provide IT services for your own company, that company is the only one you must create. Here's an example of how different types of companies participate in the life cycle of a computer. A customer company submits a purchase requisition for a computer. The customer might place the order directly or route it to either the operating company or the service provider company to do so. The order is placed with the supplier, and if the supplier doesn't have the computer in stock, it orders it from the manufacturer, who builds it. The supplier and manufacturer could be the same company. The manufacturer provides the computer to the supplier, who delivers it to the customer, the operating company, or the service provider company. The operating company or service provider company installs and configures the computer for the customer and maintains it when the customer calls for support. Companies are divided into organizations, which are further divided into departments. In menus throughout the ITSM and SLM applications, the company that you select restricts which organizations are displayed, and the organization that you select restricts which departments are displayed. Although they all use the same top-level companies, this business organization structure is different from the support group and location structures, which are described in separate videos. Organizations and departments are optional foundation data, but BMC recommends that you create them for operating companies and possibly also for vendors and customers. Next, you'll see how the business organization structure is used across the ITSM and SLM applications. When you use ITSM in multi-tenancy mode, companies partition and control access to data. A configuration item, or CI, has an owning company whose users can access it. The CI can also have relationships to other companies that use or support it, and those companies' users can also access the CI. Business service CIs, like this HR service, must be related to a company, organization, or department, which makes the service available for selection when requests are created for a customer in that organizational structure. For example, this business services relationship to Calbro Services allows Alan Albrook to select it when creating an incident for a Calbro employee. The software license management feature of BMC Configuration Management also partitions data, and both software license contracts and license certificates are owned by a company. A software CI and a license certificate can be connected only if their owning companies match. Also, the license jobs that make these connections operate against only one specified company. In a request, a company helps identify the customer for whom the request is being performed, such as on this incident for Joe Unser of Calbro Services. If you specify a separate contact for an incident, that person has a company too. Users can view the incident only when a company that they have access to is designated as the customer's company, the contact's company, or is related to the service. A company is also specified as part of the assignment of a request. This is true for high-level requests, such as this incident, problems, changes, and releases, and also for lower-level requests such as tasks, work orders, and CI unavailability records. Many other ITSM records are partitioned by company or business organization. For example, configurations, which are groups of software and hardware items usually purchased together for someone in a particular organization, have an owning company. This Calbro Services configuration can't be used by another company. In BMC Change Management, when you create a time segment to show availability for a business event or operational category, you must specify which company it pertains to. Some foundation data, including both product and operational categorization, is partitioned by company. When selecting operational categorization for this incident request, Alan Albrook is restricted to values defined for Calbro Services. You can partition workflow as well as data. For example, you can define separate approval processes and assignment routing for each company. Although you have the ability to establish separate foundation data and workflow for your companies, you are not required to create duplicate records for each company. You can choose the global company to specify that a record, such as this product categorization, applies to all companies. In the ITSM and SLM applications, companies are also used in ways that don't partition or control access to data or workflow. For example, purchase requisitions and the CIs that result from them have fields to store the manufacturer and supplier of an item. You can also specify the organizational structure that is impacted by an incident. And in SLM, you can restrict the focus of a service target based on companies and organizational structures in the object of the target. This service target for service requests applies only to Calbro Services payroll department. A user's people record shows the business organization structure they belong to. Some users have access to more than just their own company. You might not always want to see records from all your accessible companies. In all the ITSM consoles, you can filter the displayed records by company. Here, Alan Albrook displays the CIs associated with Calbro Services. You can likewise filter the data that is displayed in KPI and ROI graphs by customer company, and some standard reports also break out data by company. Before looking at configuring companies and organizations, let's review the ways that they're used in ITSM and SLM. Many kinds of data, including CIs, requests, and foundation data, are partitioned by company. Workflow, such as approval processes and assignment routing, is also partitioned by company. Some records use companies as manufacturers and suppliers, and companies or full organizational structures are also used for other labels, such as the organization impacted by an incident. Some users have access to more than one company and can filter the data in various displays to show a particular one. And any record with a company field set to global applies to all companies. To configure your organizational structures, from the Custom Configuration tab of the Application Administration Console, choose Foundation, Organizational Structures, and then Companies and Organizations. You can create an alias for a company, which serves as a shortcut for typing the company's name in many ITSM forms. You can define the organizations and departments that make up the full organizational structure for the company. You can define miscellaneous information about the company that is used in various places throughout the ITSM and SLM applications. You can set up a multi-tiered menu for users to use to select the company name in other forms, which is helpful if you are using companies to represent business units or other lower-level groups. Regions, site groups, locations, support groups, and people are discussed in other videos, so we'll skip those here. If one company provides support to another, you can give the support company's staff access to the customer company's people records. Choose Foundation, People, and then Support Company Access Configuration to configure a company as supporting another. When support staff have access to the people records of their customers, they can create requests, such as incidents, for those customers. When planning your companies, consider these points. Will one company be the default value on all forms? Does your support organization or other internal or external organizations need to be treated as separate companies in the ITSM and SLM applications? Are different workflow, processes, assets or CIs, categorization or other foundation data, or reports required for different companies? Do you need to control which users have access to data from particular business units? We hope this video has helped you understand how organizational structures are used in BMC Remedy ITSM and BMC SLM, and the basics of how they are configured. Thank you for watching.